Hello everyone, welcome to the Physics Paragons. I'm Eugene, and in this video, I'll be talking about quarks. So without further ado, let's get to it. Quarks, alongside leptons, which will be covered in a different video, are known to be among the smallest building blocks of all matter. If you have ever wondered what makes up the proton and neutron from chemistry class, the answer is quarks. Remember how atoms were once considered the smallest particles that make up matter, and how it was eventually discovered that an atom is made up of smaller things called subatomic particles like protons and neutrons? Well, the scientific community has kind of kicked the can down the road again, and this time, we have quarks officially recognized, next to the lepton, as the smallest constituent parts of matter as fundamental particles that can't be broken down any further. Will this stay true in the years to come? We just don't know. For all we know, if history repeats itself, we might discover new types of particles that compose the quark, say 20 years from now, and maybe even smaller particles than that 50 years from now, and so on. And who knows, maybe in the late 21st century, the scientific community will officially see strings rather than particles as the smallest constituent units of all matter. But anyhow, let's get back to what currently applies in the present year of 2016. Let's review a bit. If there's anything that I want you to get from watching this video, it's acknowledging that there are smaller, more fundamental particles out there than atoms, protons, and neutrons. And quarks are one of them. Let's get into more details. If you're watching this video, you might be familiar that a proton has a +1 charge and that a neutron has no charge. But why is this? What's the mechanism or reason behind this? This is where quarks and their individual flavors come into the picture. A proton is composed of 2 up quarks and 1 down quark. A neutron is composed of 1 up quark and 2 down quarks. An up quark has a fractional charge of +2/3, and a down quark has a charge of -1/3. So if you add the fractional charges for both the proton and neutron in respect to their quark compositions, you'll get 2/3 +2/3 plus a quantity of -1/3 equaling 1 for the proton, and 2/3 plus a quantity of -1/3 plus another quantity of -1/3 equaling out 0 for the neutron. This is how you would explain why protons have a +1 charge and why neutrons have no charge by doing some simple mathematics with knowledge of 2 kinds of quarks and their fractional charges. Now watch this. There are 6 different flavors of quarks: up, down, charm, strange, top, and bottom. What differentiates all these quarks from one another are their spin, charges, and mass values. And for now, these are the more important values to know about for quarks. Out of all the flavors, up and down quarks are the lightest and most common quarks as they compose the nuclei of all atoms in our universe. The other 4 quarks, however, are a slightly different story. The other 4 quarks are usually only found on Earth within active particle colliders, while up and down quarks are found in everything made up of matter. Everything from me, you, the steel that makes up the LHC, Donald Trump, a puppy, etc. And on this note, we'll wrap up our video for the discussion of quarks. Hope you enjoyed watching this video, and just an FYI, in order to have kept this video from getting too long with all the things to talk about on the subject of quarks, some things had to be left out. But don't worry, important topics to quarks, such as baryons and strong nuclear force, will be covered in different videos linked to this one either on my left or my right. Hope you enjoyed everything, and tune in next time with the Physics Paragons.